properly handled is one of the easiest ways to learn ownership or dispose of assets. Our problem is that many Ugandans have actually tried to get their schedule way of getting this land, and this has put them in a very big mess whereby they are prone to con men. On this note, the Homes and Construction Show today is bringing to you the rightful ways of acquiring your property or buying your land to avoid a stress-free process. And today with me on set, I have a specialist who is going to take us step by step on what you should look out for if you're planning on buying land. People with money are scared to invest in real estate business because they fear to be conned. Now, the reason as to why we are with you, we need you to guide us on what they should actually look out for. What is the first step if one has the money and ready to invest in real estate?
Getting a piece of land where to build a confidential home starts with an ambience for you to reclaim a future. First and foremost, you need to have the trust for the real estate company. You need to have the trust for the real estate company.
Does that mean that if I'm going to acquire land, I really should go for a real estate agency?
Not necessarily, because very many people acquire land through hereditation.
Mm-hmm.
You inherit
land.
Some people are given as gifts.
Mm-hmm.
Other people are just do the purchases.
On that very note, is where my niche is really. When you talk of purchasing land,
yes,
there are two things. I believe I can directly purchase land from the owner. Let me say, I find Daniel, you own your own property, and then I've gotten a clue that you're selling your land, so I come to buy from you. But also, others opt to go for the real estate agencies. But in this case, if I'm handling it personally, like no estate, no nothing, no agency, I'm coming to the seller. What is the first step to avoid con men?
To avoid con men, you know, elementarily speaking, there are many fraudsters in land.
Mm.
But first and foremost, what I can tell people that you need to do a site visit
of the land you intend to buy.
When you have intentions of purchase of land, first and foremost, you do the site visit.
Mm.
The second preliminary step I can tell people is you can appoint a lawyer. You can appoint the lawyer to help you in authentication or to give you authenticity of the available piece of land. Very many Ugandans do not include lawyers, but ladies and gentlemen, our dear esteemed customers, I would prefer you get a lawyer to come and give you modest authenticity. The third step, I may tell Ugandans that you may do a land title search in in the available ministry for you to avoid encumbrances.
In our case, yeah, we have Ministry of Land, we have the Uganda Land Board.
The Ministry of Land would be the very, very finest option. But some people prefer buying land, plots of land on Kabaka land.
Why?
Because with Kabaka land, the dimensions favor even a low income earner. For example,
do you mind
we can punctuate in a dimensional way approximately 25 by 50, 50 by 50 plots, 100 by 50, 100 by 100, 36 decimals on Kabaka land, which is affordable to low income earner. Yeah.
So my question here is how much money does one need to have when they are coming to purchase, like from a Kabaka land, perhaps like a 50 by 50?
that kind of question is skeptical because depending.
No, like tentatively, really.
Depending on the real estate company, they have different kind of estates, and an estate is dependent on the accessibility to the road,
the location.
The accessibility to the media services and social care services that you can elevate to build such a house you're seeing over there. It's a two-bedroom house.
What plot is that again?
Now,
what piece of land? Yeah, what's the size of the piece of land there?
It's a 25 by 50.
Yes. And I can see at least we are having kind of like two bedroom, no, okay, one bedroom, right?
It's a one bedroom, but there is also space for a toilet. And affirmatively, you can have little space for exposure.
Daniel, what do you talk about this issue whereby someone comes, they are in negotiation, they've agreed on buying a 50 by 100. You understand?
Okay.
But then we don't know the measurements. And maybe they are cheated. So at that point, what are they supposed to do? How am I supposed to know that exactly what I'm negotiating is what I'm going to pay for and it's what I'm going to get at the end of?
We always measure these plots. For us to get the arithmetic accuracy of the plots, we put barriers and we put gestures like that one, whereby you can know the boundaries of your plots. So, upon you, before you buy, we remeasure together and you affirm that it is really a 25 by 50 plot or 50 by 50. Then we can go to the next step.
Don't I remember you're helping us to go through the small steps that one needs to take to acquire land?
Yes.
And here I'm looking at a scenario where I am buying from someone from China Mukaka. You get it?
You're buying for someone in China
Mukaka. Uh-huh. Directly from maybe, like directly from the owner. I'm not saying that the real estate agencies aren't owners, but if I'm not getting the land or the plot from an organized estate and I'm just getting from an individual, how will I know that this is the exact size?
That is when I can tell an individual over there to procure or choose a very trustworthy surveyor to help you affirm the land size. Yeah, you get a surveyor to help you affirm the land size.
So now you have told us that number one, we need to do the site visit. We need to get the lawyer. We need to get a surveyor, right? What are the other, like, what happens after that?
After acquiring a surveyor and he has given you the right dimensions of a piece of land, then you sit down on the table and negotiate with the real estate, with that person or individual you intend to buy land from. The surveyor will also guide you on the dimensions.
Now, with the negotiations, what do you mean by that?
Negotiation is preparation for payment according to the land rates.
Yeah, for instance, I can ask for a discount.
That is when someone has possessively told you that, you know what, I'm going to add up my piece of plot to this amount because of this and this and this. So you can negotiate accordingly, because some people prefer accessibility to the feeder road, water, electricity, and social primary health care services.
Now that means that different services are considered or attribute a lot to the negotiating power.
Those services really attribute a lot, ladies and gentlemen, because when you look at such an estate here, proximity to the road is 2 kilometers strictly. It is walkable. You don't need a border. You don't need a cyclist. You don't need a car. You can walk to the main road and access whatever you want. So this opportunity that has come away from these people is grossly inevitable. It is, wow, it's astounding.
Yeah, I can see. And we are very privileged that we are having you on the show today. and you're still taking us on those procedures to follow to have a stress-free land acquisition. So now, after negotiating, what happens next?
Now, okay, after preparation for the sales agreement, you can then undergo a process of looking at the land rates. Then you prepare for the concept of transfer. The concept of transfer is you can go for a registry of the stamp duty, get the right fees to clear. Then you go on and get your piece of land in the rightful procedure. Yes.
What is the rightful procedure? Because we are here for you to guide us. You know what is happening, Daniel? People are having money. They are having money, but they don't know what to do, number one, and they don't also trust people. Because everyone wants to be like, ah, mfunilamu, why? They also want to take some kathinka. So they want to know by themselves what to do to get land by themselves.
Okay, what I know is there are different types of land systems in Uganda. Mm. But preferably, people in Uganda are undertaking, most of them, a private milo. Most of them are doing milo land system.
Mm.
Or they prefer purchase in milo land systems.
Mm.
You get it? Some people fear the freehold because they're limited to the rights of ownership and the rights of use. You get it? That's why I'm telling people that the process of acquisition of land is chronological. It involves step by step. You don't need to hurry because you may land yourself into land grabbers and then you lose out your money to the concept of faith. Yes. So once you've really acclaimed to the perfect land tenure system, you always have to undertake a search, as we said. You know the property type. Then you may also know for low-lying areas, for example, areas, I may advise people, you consult the NEMA before you ascertain payment. For low-lying areas like swampy areas, you can always consult with NEMA before purchase of such land.
You mentioned the land tenure system. Yeah. Which type of land am I, all title, land tenure, am I not supposed to? Daniel, I need you to guide us on how to prepare the sales agreement.
Affirmatively, some people, when they're making sales agreements, they prefer to make them from policymakers like chairmen of the villages, of the counties. Okay, like people like who have rights in specified areas. Some other people are, when they're preparing those sales agreements, they prefer to come with their witnesses to adhere to the consent of transfer or making of an agreement. So when you're preparing for the sales agreement, you always have to be safe and sound. You have to have the mindful set. You have to make the right decision with the rightful people when making that sales agreement, and make sure that you're buying exactly from the real owner of the land. You make sure that you have to always sign a signatory of the owner and the owner, or you can say the past, the buyer. You get also the stamp verification from the local authorities. Others get them from real estate companies. Then for Milo land, some people are always channeled to where they will pay their, you know,
stamp duty.
Yeah, the duties. The transfer and getting a title is for a different system of land.
Yeah.
There are specific kind of tenure system. For example, there is purchase of land whereby you only need an agreement and you get the right to use the land.
In this case, because many people really, between me and you, know that they always ask, is it titled land? Now, in that case, it means that there would be a transfer. So how, at what point and at what stage do we transfer the land title from the mother title, maybe, or from the seller to the one buying?
That point is when the buyer wants to transfer in his or her names to get real and full ownership whatsoever on that piece of land. So upon buying, some people punctuated this way, that when you finish the money, sometimes when you've paid maybe half, I'll give you a transfer upon making full payment. The transfer gives you the rights to use it in your nature or names. You get it?
Mm.
With the full rights.
Mm.
You get it? So once a title is in my names, some people leave it hanging because they intend to buy for resale. So they leave it hanging for the next transaction. You get it?
Mm.
Yeah. For the case of Kabaka land, you don't need... some people just buy and use the land as it is.
Daniel, as you...
But they may as well get title of Uganda Land Board.
Okay, now, like, as you has been in this for a long time, eh? What advice do you give our people out there who have intentions of acquiring land but have a phobia of con men, have a phobia of, like... Something somewhere can go wrong. What advice can you
give? The advice I can give people out there who are preparing to buy land and they fear instances of con men or land grabbers, or you may choose a rightful real estate company. There are very many, you can Google them around. But then you have to make sure that you keep your documents, because there may arise an issue that or a court issue, and you don't need any document. So in exchange of your money for piece of land, please, the document that you've bought free is the password to reclaim your money in case of anything. So you keep those documents safely. The other thing is, some people, please do a very, very, very thorough search for the details of that land. Go to the chairman, go to the district attorneys, go to the RDC, ask the neighborhood, get a chance to engage in that kind of peace talk with people, asking them about the land, the prior land that you want to purchase, and get the full details. Sometimes you go on purchasing a land that has grudges, that has disputes, that has wrangles, then you end up losing your money. So do thorough search about a specific piece of land. Choose the rightful real estate developer or real estate company that is going to help you make the rightful decision upon purchase of land. They'll always give you advice. They'll always tame you in this kind of land.
Acquisition. Thank you very much, Daniel. It was a pleasure, like, really so much having you on set, and I believe our people there have learned something. To our viewers, we promised you that we will always try our best to get you the best information that you need to know when it comes to real estate business. Today, we have learned that it is very, very important when you're purchasing or when you're intending to buy land, you must go for a site visit. This helps you to know exactly the location you're going to buy land from. It's also going to help you understand the kind of neighborhood the neighbors you're having. And you should not forget involving a lawyer. Lawyers will always help you with things that you don't understand. You will always have to get a surveyor, so that you get to know that the piece of land, your plot of land you're taking, is exactly that, to avoid being cheated. We thank you so much for being with us. Don't also forget to always make the sales agreement and have your transfer. Let that land be transferred into your names.